Module 3 is observing modifiability during dynamic assessment. For my speaker disclosures, I have financial disclosure that I'm a professor and associate dean at the University of California at Irvine, and I receive financial compensation from ASHA. So today we're going to talk about what is modifiability. What should we look for when we are observing modifiability during the teaching phase of dynamic assessment? And how do we describe and quantify modifiability? So what is modifiability? Modifiability helps us describe child responsiveness given examiner effort. So sometimes we might have a situation where we have low examiner effort and the child's responsiveness is really high. So they pick up on things right away with just some basic instruction. And maybe that's a case where the child just didn't know what to do with a task. But once they receive some instruction, they figure they're highly responsive. Sometimes we have situations where the examiner effort is really high, but then the child's responsiveness is really low. And this is a situation where that I think we've all had where you work really, really hard and then the child, you know, has a lot of difficulty no matter what you do, no matter how many hints or how many supports you give them. And for me, this is an indicator of possible developmental language disability. And sometimes we have other combinations. So we might have high effort and high effort on the part of the examiner and medium responsiveness. So it's really important to think about our own level of effort and then how responsive the child is given that level of effort. One of the things that I've worked on over the years is to think about what to look for. So it turns out that modifiability is very predictive of children's ability in the linguistic domain. So kids with DLD tended to have a lot of or lower responsiveness or lower modifiability. And so I've been playing with this idea of how do we bottle this or how do we look for what's involved in child modifiability. So these are the kinds of things we've looked at, social emotional domains, through observation in terms of is the child displaying any of these things and do they need support to lower anxiety or to increase motivation. And that's on the social emotional side. And then on the cognitive side, we look at things like how well do they orient to a task? Are they good at problem solving? Do they verbally mediate or talk themselves through the task? How flexible are they? If you try it one way, can they do that? And then if you try it a different way, can they quickly switch tasks? Now we have found through a number of research projects that things like compliance, task orientation, metacognition, and flexibility are areas that are strong predictors of DLD. So the more support they need to end the task, to understand like the goal of the task and where they need a lot of help in flexibility and paying attention and complying with the situation. Those are kids who had tended to have difficulties in the language domain. So now that we've explored the concept of modifiability, in the next activity, we're going to review some evidence and some examples. So we're going to observe and describe modifiability. So how do we quantify what modifiability is? We know that it's really a powerful way, but how do we capture that and how do we describe it? So this is based on some work that that I've done with Maria Resendiz, with Ron Gillum, with several people over the last few years, where we're trying to describe modifiability in these two domains. And so you can see that this is scored on a scale from 1 to 5, and where the 5 is that they needed a lot of support to say lessen anxiety, and 1 that they needed very little support. So in this scheme, the lower score is a better score, right, in terms of child modifiability. So we have scaled this out so that we have descriptors of each of these. So for anxiety, for example, they didn't need any soothing, they're calm, they, you know, orient to the task well, they're enthusiastic, they're persistent. 2, you know, they might be distraught, or they can't be soothed, or they don't want to engage, or they reject the task. These are other elements of the social emotional aspect of modifiability, so responsiveness to feedback, attention, and compliance. And again, we've scaled this out from a 1 to a 5, and compliance is bolded because this is one of the areas that has shown to be most effective at differentiating typical development from DLD. So are they cooperative, or do they refuse to do the task? So that's just one of the elements. On the cognitive side, we look at similar things. So orientation, metacognition, and nonverbal self-rewards. Are they aware of their errors, and are they responding positively to their to the task? So again, task orientation and metacognition are 2 of the areas that predict DLD. And we score this again on a 1-5 basis, 5 being a lower score, indicating that they need a lot of support to orient to task, or to use, or to become more aware of what it is they're doing, or to reward themselves. So they're not necessarily aware of what they're doing, or they respond negatively, even if a task is really, really easy, or if a task is too hard for them, they're just rejecting what it is that you're doing. And then the final 3 items look at problem solving, verbal mediation, and flexibility. And so again, flexibility is highly predictive of children's language ability. And so kids use multiple strategies pretty readily, tend to be good language learners. And so this again is going to help us to identify children with language disabilities. So we score on a lot on all of these using this scale. So now we've explored the concept of child modifiability and reviewed some examples, and next activities are going to be your turn to practice. So here's your plan statement, and here you want to think about how to systematically observe child learning during mediated learning experience. So I've given you a couple of ways to do that, looking at examiner effort and child responsivity, and then more systematically drilling into the social emotional aspects of learning and the cognitive aspects of learning, and you can use those to systematically observe how efficiently the child is learning. Think about, how does the child approach a new task? Are they aware of the goals? How flexible are they in employing new strategies? Now, spend 5 minutes at work putting your plan into action. And if you don't have a way of doing that, just think a little bit about your own level of effort in teaching any new task. You know, how do you gauge, how do you know if it's a high level of effort or a low level of effort? How do you encourage and support children's use of learning strategies during teaching phase of dynamic assessment? And then think about what happened. What are your reflections? What worked and what where might you improve? So modifiability is the interaction of effort or examiner effort and child responsiveness. So think about other strategies that a child might need that in order to learn a new task or the kind of task that you might have in mind, more approaches that you as the examiner can use to support the learning process.